We are continuing to follow breaking news from Capitol Hill. The House just wrapping up a vote on the first of two bills to bring aid to victims of Superstorm Sandy. And joining me now, New York Congressman Michael Grimm, who was a vocal critic of the House's failure to bring the bills up to vote sooner. And with a welcome to you, sir, give me a status of where we are right now. We had that procedural vote, the suspension vote, that passed. And the actual vote now, has it been completed? Is it a done deal?
The suspension vote is actually probably down to its last few votes, but from what I'm hearing, it will pass without incident. I think the last check was over 200 votes in favor of it, less than 12 against it. So with a two-thirds majority that you need on a suspension vote, this will pass in just another few minutes. So it's pretty much a done deal on the $9 billion plus for the flood insurance portion of this relief package.
Okay, which must come as great relief to you to a degree, but it's not anywhere near what you need. I mean, this group, the Club for Growth, is urging members of the House to vote no on today's bill. But again, this is the smaller of these two aid packages the House votes on. We heard you earlier this week. You said that you felt stabbed in the back by Boehner. So do you think you can count on him now to help pass both of these two bills, especially with this debt debate taking center stage?
You know, I do, unequivocally, and we had the New York, New Jersey delegation sat in a conference room with the speaker and the majority leader, and I stayed afterwards just to shake his hand and look in his eyes and ask the speaker on a personal level, will this vote come forward on the 15th? And he gave me his assurances, and that's all I need. I trust John Boehner. We are going to have this vote on the 15th. Now listen, the speaker doesn't guarantee what members will do. So that there's still a big lift here. I have a lot of work to do, and I shoulder that burden without any reservation. We have the votes that we have to get. All the New York, New Jersey delegation is going to work as a team to make sure that our colleagues, enough of them, vote to pass the legislation. So that's the big lift now, and that's not on the speaker's back. That's on mine, and I'm committed. I'm telling everyone in Staten Island, I'm committed to getting it done.
Look, a lot of lawmakers go and ask for handouts and donations and campaign funding to the states of New York and New Jersey. According to Politico, you've got New York residents having given, what, $378 million to candidates during the last year of elections, New Jersey residents giving $98 million. Do you think the fight within the Republican Party over Sandy aid votes irrevocably damages the GOP brand in the Northeast states like yours?
Ultimately, I don't think it's going to make a difference. But I look at things very differently because I'm in the heart of it. I could care less about fundraising and all of that. What I think about is the people that are devastated and displaced, and you know, the young children that haven't been able to go back to their homes and their rooms and not sure if they're ever going to get back there. This is the human effort, and I think that all of my colleagues need to remember the faces, the actual people that we represent, whether you live in that district or not. These people are hurting, and they're completely, completely devastated. We need to be there for them, and that's going to be what I'm going to talk about when I speak to my and ask them for their vote. It's the personal, really, outpouring of need, and I have to have them understand that, and I think they're coming around. Bottom line is, I'm going to get the votes.
Speaker Boehner won re-election yesterday with the smallest margin of any speaker since the 1990s. Are you confident in his ability to lead your own caucus?
Oh, I'm very confident in his ability to lead. What I think that is representative of is where we are right now as a nation. We have a very polarized nation. We have some of the biggest challenges this country has ever faced, and it's very, very difficult. Listen, the speaker has, next to the president, the most difficult job in the world, and we have a very outspoken conference that is sometimes very difficult to get a consensus in, and that's really what Speaker Boehner put on the table. He wants the House to work its will. That's a courageous thing to do. I admire him for that, but when you allow the House to work its will, you're certainly going to have malcontents, and you're going to have those that voice their opinion in opposition. So I just think it's representative of the times and representative of just the turmoil of the overall country and how polarized we are, but I think the fact that he's able to step up and allow the House to work its will shows you the leadership that he really has, and he certainly has my admiration and respect for doing it.
All right, Congressman Michael Grimm of New York, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Marching for immigration.